In the left side, you'll find the layout option and drag and drop the vertical arrangement like this and make this hide and with it like fill parent like this. Okay. Now, in the left side, you see the button, just drag and drop the button also here in the bottom. So I'm going to just drag and drop that button out of that layout and make that the screen will be like center, horizontal and the vertical. Click on that button and just change that name to restart game like this. And font size is like maybe 18 and make this font bold. Change the background color of that button is something to green is like this, dark green. And okay, and change the text color to white like this. Now this is our main screen of our game. Now in the left side, you'll see the extension option. Click on extension and we need to download the extension, okay. Close this layout interface. Now you can see this is the website. I will give you that website link. You need to click on the download latest, this extension EIX file, download this. And now go to the MIT App Inventor, click on import extension, click on choose file. And you can see that this is the puzzle view extension. Just open this. Now just drag and drop that puzzle view extension like this. Let's go to the block. So click on the puzzle view and you can see here the create layout. So just drag and drop this. Click on the screen. Whenever our screen will initialize, it means our game or our app will open. So we need to use this. Okay. So screen will initialize, then layout. We need to choose the layout and that is the vertical arrangement. Like just drag and drop here. The block X and Y, it means that like, you know, you can play by 3x3 or 4x4 or 5x5. So I think 3 and 4 is the max here. So I'm going to use here the 3x3. So click on the max and just drag and drop here the 3 and the same thing is like 3. This is puzzle is by 3x3. Cool. Now let's click on the puzzle view and you will see here once our puzzle is complete, then we can use here notifier to display that your game is done or your winner. So click on the user interface and you'll see the notifier. Just drag and drop this. Go to the block. Click on notifier. After completing this, we'll show dialog box, this one. And message is something. Okay, winner or like you won the game. Like this. And just title is winner. And button text is like, okay, like this. Okay, but we need to check that if that is, there is a game over also. So click on puzzle view, you will see here the option of if the game is over. You can see this dot is game over. So we need to check. So how we can check that? So for that, we can use here the timer. Okay, or we can use it every step. So it's better to use that on the timer. So go to the designer and you can see here the option of sensor and just use the clock and then run this in every second. Go to the block and once this clock is running, so every time we need to check, so use the control, use if else condition. If it's like if that game is over, then we call this notifier here and in this notifier, we can just see here, game over. Okay. In the title is also game over and button text is restart. Restart game. Okay. Like this. Message is game over. Title is game status. Okay. Like this. Cool. So this is our game. Now let's play this, how this, that will work. Okay. So for that, you can just go to the design. And let's click on the connect. I'm going to use your AI companion. So you can see that's the game here. As you can see, this is the game. Once you open this, that will look like this. So you can play like this. So you need to match the same number and you need to complete the 2048 in any tab. Okay. So how we can do this? So as you can see here, I can see like this. So what I need to do here, like this, 4, like this, just 482. Like this, once that you can't match, okay, so you'll see here the game will over like this. See the game over. You can see this pop-up is again coming. So for that, you can do just go to the block or you can just clock should be, timer should be disabled after game. Once the game is over, you can just timer should be false, like this. Okay, and the same thing you need to call it once you restart the game. So where's the restart button? Oh, there's no restart button. So let's do this. So how we can do this? So once people click on button 1, it means the restart button, like this. So we need to call that timer should enable. Okay, that should be enabled, true. And one more thing is, like, click on the puzzle view, you will see the restart game, this one, like this. So that's the overall game. Now let's click on the refresh, go to here, and I need to just remove that restart. Okay, yes, done. You can see you can play that game like this. Once that fill, so your game will over like this. Okay, that is filled. Oh yes, it's filled. Game over. Restart game. Let's click on the restart button again, right? So this is the overall game. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.